think in many member states, the European tools are mainly used for transnational mobility in the first hand, and that's what they were made for in the Copenhagen process. And if you look to the mobility rates in Europe, they are about only 2 or 3% for the target population, for example, in BED. So just a small part of the youth that can participate in that instruments. That's true for Europass, that's true for ECVET. But there is a trend in the European policy also to establish these instruments for national systems and to install them in the national systems, not just for transnational mobility, horizontal. So I think it's still a way to go to implement them and also to have the possibilities to adapt them to national specificities. And this is a process that is going on. So I would not say the instruments are not successful, but they started with mobility where we had our limits from financial reasons and other reasons. And we are now in the process of getting them implemented. But education is a big boat and it takes a long time to make things happen in systems. So give it a couple of years.
So how could apprenticeships and use of technology as tools help in the longer term development of European tools? Mm-hmm.
I think if we come to apprenticeships, there is no blueprint. Also, the German system is no blueprint, and it's not possible to transfer or take over a complete system. But what you can take and transfer our principles, for example, the principle of good cooperation of industry together with schools already in the early stage of general schools with vocational orientation, vocational guidance. What you can take is a more practical in the vocational school-based training process and step by step involve social partners, stakeholders of the labor market into the education system. And that's what we are trying with several instruments also on a bilateral scale from Germany with I think now 6-7 countries, other European countries. But we are very much in favor and very much support also the European Alliance for Apprenticeship, because this gives a European platform and Cedefop plays an important role there as catalyst for transferring this kind of dual principles. And if you just look to the unemployment rates, you know that better than me, the European unemployment rates of those countries with dual systems are much lower than with school-based systems.
From the point of view of a member state, and especially Germany, how do you think we can work to make all these efforts materialize?
I think what we need is more clarity on instruments and elements of instruments. One core thing is learning outcomes. In ECVET, it's the basis. In ESCO, it's the basis. In the European Qualification Frameworks, learning outcomes are the instruments. And we trust and believe in learning outcomes also in Germany because they are the currency. While keeping your national systems, which are very different in education, having a kind of common currency for transfer of learning results. Yeah? But what we don't have for the time being is a definition. We don't have a clear view, a European view on the size of learning outcomes that you would need in order to transfer them. And we don't have so far possibilities to measure learning outcomes, at least common principles for measurement. As long as we don't have this, and that's the core field for the future work from my point of view on a European scale, the trust among member states according learning outcomes will not be so big. If you look to the European Qualification Framework, for example, many things were set on the different levels via learning outcomes, but no one knows in the member states from each other how they did it. So the trust is pretty still low, though we have now a common matrix. The trust and the mobility was not much, did not become better. So we need more content clarity on learning outcomes. And that's for me, as I said, a priority for the next years.